Buongiorno. I am getting ready to go to my spa appointment, which when I checked the desk last night, I asked them if there were any messages for me, and they said they didn't have any. And when I checked my phone, I had like 25 missed calls, and I don't know why they didn't leave a message, but the desk didn't have any messages for me and said that the spa doesn't open any earlier, even though the woman said she was going to see if she could get me in sooner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go downstairs and check and see if my appointment is able to be started a little bit early still. But anyway, I slept like a baby. Oh my gosh, this place is so cozy and so comfortable. And the bed was so beautiful. I didn't want to get out. It was a real thing. I have a king size bed at home, and once you've had a king, it's hard to get out. Even though I used to be quite content with a queen, it's nice to have the entire bed to yourself. All right, let's go downstairs, and then I'm going to go up to the terrace again and see about getting some sun too after my massage. All right, here's something that's a little funny. I only just saw this. Ms. Labonte would like to inform you that the massage at the spa will start at 11:30 on October 4th, which is today. Why didn't they tell me that? I don't know. I mean, honestly, I just didn't notice it because I didn't look for it. But anyway, so now we're gonna go down the street, down the hall to the elevator. And yes, I am in my towel. I feel weird walking around like this. Isn't it just me? I mean, everybody else was doing it though. So I'm just gonna wear the slippers. This is a very small room, I noticed. So I won't be able to do any video inside the spa when I go in there, but it's okay because you don't need to see everything, right? But I would like to go to the rooftop today. I guess they open at 8 a.m. Huh, I didn't know that. I am alone, by the way, which is nice. I also get usually showers. The Turkish wet sauna is not working. I am going to start in the hot sauna in here. Oh yeah, this is perfect. This is what I need. I'm going to change and take off my bikini though, because I like to do it au naturel. I don't like stuff sticking to my body. This is what I should, because this is closed. And it's really sweet, because it's not working out that shower. This is the wet sauna. And it's not working. No problem. Alright, I'm going for my massage and facial. Blue, calming, cooling energy. I'm gonna have to obviously edit that out. I started to think I wasn't showing, but I nipped it. I'll nip that out. Anyway, time for my facial and my massage, and I'm so ready for this. I feel like a natural woman. Hydrated, that is. Okay. I just needed all of that. So I'm going to the sixth floor. Actually, no, I need to go to my room first because I was gonna go grab a couple of biscotti and go up by the pool, get some water. Actually, maybe I'll get it in the water room and try to see if there's room for me to take a little sun in. I need some sun, some vitamin D, and then cappuccino too. So peaceful. Smells so nice on my floor too. I'm gonna quickly go grab those so that they can do whatever they need to do in the room. Yeah. And I'm back. Grazie. I can't wait to try the biscotti. I have a baggie of biscotti. These are raw vegan. gluten-free. And now I'm gonna go upstairs. And I also washed some underwear last night. Sometimes I just can't stand dirty underwear in my bag, even if I bring them home and clean them when I get there. It's just a thing, just saying. Okay, let's go up to the terrace. And this is the pool bar. Buongiorno. I wanted to come up here to get some time in the sun before I go walk around after my beautiful experience. Let's go see if there's a space. Oh yeah, I've got space up here. This is perfect. I think I picked a good time. Even with the noise of construction, I was definitely the thing in Europe. Mm-hmm. I should have brought my hat up, actually. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. I can't find myself at the place. The sunshade down just to cover my face. Beyond that, I'm in heaven. Beautiful heaven. Looking at the terrace. Ah. Relax for a little bit. I'm waiting on my cappuccino. This just arrived. I also asked for some water. I forgot to ask for it earlier. My cappuccino. Mm-hmm. Yummy. And this is the 3 chocolates. And the poolside with beautiful music. After my massage and spa appointment, this is my treat to myself. Cappuccino and 3 chocolate mousse poolside. Different way to have coffee today. Poolside. In my hotel. Con sole. Oh, this is good. This is the way to live. Cheers to another day in Rome. And just a little bit of the 3 chocolates. That's gluten-free. And the perfect compliment. Mm. Oh, welcome home. First, I asked if the triple chocolate mousse was gluten-free. I didn't say I wanted it. But while I was laying here, I thought, I should have said, if it's gluten-free, I'll take it. And then I thought, well, maybe I don't want it. But he brought it out to me. I can only say this much. That was so delectable, so delicious, so melt in your mouth, mousse, creme, creamy, that it didn't last, and it was a perfect compliment to my cappuccino, even though I brought my little raw biscuits with me. And I can tell you, yummy. Lana's lick of approval, just saying. Sunshine on my body. Makes me happy. Oh, and I can't see a damn thing. It's so bright out here. My phone keeps going dark, so I can't even see my reflection or anything. When you feel something on your back and you're not sure if you want to swat at it because it could end up being a wasp, aka a Vespa, I'm like, what the hell? It keeps landing on my back, and I'm like, I don't need another Vespa bite, which is what this on my arm was. That was from the Vespa when I was in Venice. Can you believe that? It left a mark like that. It's so perfect out right now. Even with the clouds, it's perfect. It's just a refreshing, relaxing day. And then in a little bit, I'm gonna go get dressed. Oh, see, I just felt it. It's on my back again. Tell me what that is. I can't tell. Either way, it's bugging me. I'm gonna get ready to go in a little bit. Just to give you perspective, the afternoon, storm, clouds. Doesn't mean they're gonna drop any rain, but this is overhead. It's a little dark. Ominous, but not. The wind is actually coming from my back, so I think it'll be fine. I love the music. Very shamanic. Piano bar. Yep. Pleasant. Peaceful. Imagine what he's thinking of looking over here. Enjoying myself. That's enough sun. Go back to my room and change. Hello. Time to explore. Okay. I have my stuff, I'm all ready, a little dress, being cute, with my hair braided, it's just easier to work with. Plus, because my nails have grown out, they keep catching in my hair and ripping. So we have the iconic hat. Keep the sun out of my face. I have a little bit of a poofiness, but that's because that massage and the facial really, really like cleared me up and I feel so much better. I'm glad I got some time to rest up at the pool. I have to go check and see what time my late check-in is. Check out? Yeah. What time I'm going to check out tomorrow. And what time my girlfriend will come and pick me up because I'm going to spend the day with her and her daughters. Yay! So I'm going to head toward the Spanish Steps. I'm going to swing by Ginger. I recall they have plant-based options and also like smoothies and all sorts of yumminess. And I'm kind of in the mood for a salad, actually. Something light. I didn't get a lot of vegetables or fruit yesterday, so I need to remedy that. Okay, let's go. That's my room. Open sesame. And down we go. Hello, darling.
Smile.
I'm a little wrinkly, but this is kind of like a gauze material, like a cottony, linen-y. I'm not sure if it was linen or cotton. I'm pretty sure it's cotton. I'll tell you what, it's really comfy, and I got a little skirt underneath. And sneakers to boot. That was quick. Okay, we need to go find out. Check out this. I want to look at these beautiful. Look at my lines. Look how pretty. Look how handsome. I love it. It's a beautiful hotel. I'm very happy to be staying here. They're so like calm, unless they need to be otherwise. So I'm gonna head back to the Spanish Steps and it is so pleasant outside. Like, this is perfect weather. This is the kind of weather I like. So there's enough moisture in the air. I'm actually breathing much better. I'm so grateful for my morning, my relaxing start to the day. Mm-hmm. And my checkout will be at 1 p.m. or 3 p.m. Depends on if there's someone who's supposed to be coming to my hotel room sooner. So I can check that and I could stay longer if I need to. But I'm going to send a message to my girlfriend, let her know. And yeah, I'm excited.
So even though you saw that last night, you get to see it in the daytime too. Of the man, or should call him a merman. was talking about the contrast between these different buildings. It's just amazing how the different time periods and all the attention to detail in architecture. It is sunny. Look at those doors.
How gorgeous is that? See how big it is? Dark to see these doors really on when you really zoom in. We got a bus in front of you. How gorgeous is that? Really, really pretty.
I'm in a Shente, which used to be a place I used to shop a lot in Naples, but they closed the one that was down by me. I think that was on Via Toledo. But I don't know why they closed it. I don't know if it's, is it open? I don't know, it looks like it's under some kind of renovation or something. Maybe I'm wrong. It looks like, no, it's open. And this is Salome Margarita that I passed last night. Again, it was dark. Next theater, straight ahead. We're looking at Piazza di Spagna area. Windy. Nice breeze, I should say. I'm enjoying it. It's like perfect. Hopefully it's not making too much feedback in the wind department.
Where's that statue from last night?
Size of those statues on the base of it. You know what I meant to do last night? Just wipe up my shoe. It's kind of gross and messy still.
Sticky.
Sticky. Those are the taxi drivers behind us having a conversation. Okay. You want to do a little window shopping? Oh, that's what I like to do.
Speaks to me. I like to have a new purse every once in a while. It's been kind of a while since I've had a new bag. The one I have with me right now is definitely durable and seen so much. All right, let's go. There's a line to go into Dior. He's just about to. This man just asked his girlfriend to marry him. That's what everybody's clapping about.
That's a beautiful way to ask. Take your loved one on a trip and ask them to marry you. How sweet is that? I wouldn't mind that.
Stairs in, go up and down these stairs a couple times to get it. Sweet. Okay. Dior had a line. I'm gonna see if the other one is open. It doesn't look like it. Maybe? Maybe a shorter line. So right here is a bead necklace. I'm in Christian Dior and I'm gonna try that. That's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Okay, what do you think? Queen bee. I won't sting, but it's good luck too. I really like it. Rose gold, diamonds, beauty. I am about to gift myself Queen Bee, limited edition too. I don't know, this is tempting too, from necklace. A limited edition ring too. What do you think? The bees always find me.
How beautiful is that?
So I am here enjoying a beautiful acqua frizzante in the cafe. I love that. And this is Fabrizio, beautiful man, studied ballet in Paris. Isn't that beautiful? Mm-hmm. And he captures the balance of life.
Yeah.
And you can see the Spanish steps out the window. How beautiful. All the people. It's actually kind of nice because it's not very packed.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
Like I said, when in Rome. Buon caffè. Solo in Italia.
Sì, ciao mamma.
J'adore. Amor. I literally feel like a little girl who just got a present for herself. Oh my gosh. So happy. Okay, Spanish stuff's behind me. Now to go find Todd's. Straight ahead.
You gotta pass all the beauty stores, you know what I mean? Just to get to the right ones. And this is all Bulgari. I actually have a beautiful ring that I bought from Bulgari years ago. It's got amethyst ring all around. Kind of like one of these, but a smaller version. Yeah, these are the baguettes. Love it. Alright. Here we go. St. Laurent is another place I'd like to go. Grazie. Hello, buonasera.
I'm going to tell you right now, people forget about the attitudes and the impressions they make on you. Attenzione. Like, I walked in there and I didn't feel like a customer. In fact, the attitudes I got from Yves Saint Laurent, which I love and I enjoy, I have never been treated like. It was just really weird. So I wouldn't recommend the one in Rome, by the way. And I've been in there before, years ago. It was totally different people. I'm liking the Salvatore Ferragamo's got some nice looking stuff in there, purse-wise. I gotta go in there and really look in the window. Yeah. Check your attitudes, people. Kindness to everyone. Be a good human.
Oh, yeah. Look up. Again, beautiful doors. Looking around. I'm just enjoying walking around. I would go into Hermes, but I think I'm good for scarves now. I just got a scarf in Christian Dior, so. Although, I really like this hat. I have to check the hat, actually. So we are going inside. So I came in because I love this hat. It's wool, but also look at the way this scarf is. It's got its own little pull-through hole. I love that. If you didn't know, Hermes is one of my favorites. How pretty.
What do you think? Is it my color? It's a pretty blue.
I love the entry of this place. Look at my beautiful doors. Albergo. That's a hotel. No, it's beautiful. Sweet. Okay. Let's make our way to Todd's. I just came out of Hermes and tried on that hat. Yeah. I loved it. Favorite bag ever. I love it too. It's the best classic bag I've ever owned.
It's the best
leather.
Mm-hmm.
This one.
Soft.
The name is Bacchetta.
Bacchetta?
Yeah, it's the same of these.
Oh, yeah. It's just like the chairs. You're right. And the scarpe? Yeah, like the shoes.
Bellissima. Yeah.
Grazie.
Natti.
Questo. Bellissima. This is my bag they're talking about.
And the same color. The name is Natti.
It's my favorite bag ever.
Yeah.
I wanted the shorter one, but I'm glad I got this one.
Cream,
no, the not in quarter. Cream. Maybe I need to clean it because it's due. Oh, I like these. These are super cute. I think I found my next bag, and it's going to be one of these small ones because it's just super cute. All right, this is what we're looking at. So the way that this bag, it actually snaps in the center. It's the same bag as this, which I actually like the orange. The orange is really beautiful, and even that one is really nice with the crochet styling. But what I like is you can do this. It's the same bag, so it's secured in the center, so nobody can kind of reach in. You can leave it open. What do you think? This is challenging choices. We all got choices to make. She had to pull out the security thing that was stuck in my bag, which she accidentally left in there. But anyway, her name was Carla, and she was very helpful, and they were such beautiful ladies, and I'm so grateful for the amazing staff at Todd's in Rome. Now let's go eat at Ginger. That guy's actually, the guy who started Ginger is from Naples. And when I met him years ago, I was like, you're kidding me, right? The funny part is though, he was smoking cigarette and I was like, that was back then. We'll see now. Look at that moon above the light. How cool is that? All right, so I pretty much am happy for, there's gonna be more stuff to carry on my airplane ride, but it is what it is, and I'm happy just the same. Treating myself well is important too. Wow, that moon is stunning. And look at the glow. I don't know if you can see the glow the way I see it, but it is a glow. So we are heading over here for Ginger. Ginger's actually right next to the place I ate at last night, or in the same area, I should say. If I'm not mistaken, this is Ginger. Yes, it is. I'm going to go find a place inside. I don't want to sit outside. Although it's nice and pleasant. This is where we are. And it's really cool inside because there's like lots of plants. It's got a high ceiling. It's got a beautiful entry. So, right, he's going to take me inside and we get to see how beautiful. See how beautiful food. All the fruits back there. Teono.
One of the sweats at the beginning.
Okay. Va bene, grazie. Grazie. I know tonight's going to be an early night because I am so tired just from having my massage and facial that it brought up, like, my eyes feel really tired. And then getting some sun, which is what I really needed anyway. Do you like my new bee? I'm very happy. And I'm gonna have to figure out what I wanna eat here. And this is Ginger. And we have the menus. And I am sitting by the window, door, technically. Listings of the different fruits up on the wall, mangoes, all the different types. There's over there, smoothies and juices. It's good to go. It's really nice in here. Very modern. Ordered a juice because I need the fruit juice for vitamins, and it's going to have fennel, pineapple, ginger, apple,
and something else. I can't remember what. Ordered the juice, and then I ordered a salad, and I already know the dessert. I got some more greens sautéed, which I'm pretty sure it's like the friarielli, which is like a rabe. And then for dessert, there's a pistachio dessert I saw on the menu that I'm probably gonna get as well. I am starving, and I'm so tired, and I'm going to bed early tonight. All right, here we go. This is the ginger drink, which I really need. Oh, it has fennel in it. I'm excited. Pineapple, fennel, apple, and ginger, which I need. A salad. And this is the wrapping. This is how you eat when you're in Rome. Beautiful ginger, fresh squeezed juice. Insalata, Paolina. And then we have what I believe is friarielli, yummy. I am going to eat like a queen. Dessert is heaven, yummy. This is when you know you're in heaven. Gluten-free, dairy-free, raw vegan chocolate, and pistachio mousse inside. I am gonna devour this. You have to see me cut into it to really appreciate what is really inside. Pistachio mousse with a cashew crust. Pistachio is my favorite. That mixed with chocolate, and you're golden. Well, that was delicious. Now I'm gonna go back to the hotel and relax and go to sleep, because honestly, I am spent. I did a little bit more shopping, but today was my day, like really my day. Wrapping up this entire trip. I'll be back. Story time. So Patrizia Pepe. That's actually the husband and wife's name. Giuseppe is Pepe and Patrizia is the wife. Now, the story goes, I'm gonna walk and talk, but basically, they're from Naples. And when I was changing locations, basically I had to leave Naples, and I was leaving my old apartment that had the view of the Bay of Naples. He was getting ready to rent it, so he came up to look at the apartment before I was leaving, and Pepe came up to the apartment, Giuseppe, came up to my apartment to look at it before he decided to rent it from my old landlord, and he saw what I had for furniture, and he was like, wow, you know, I just moved all my stuff, all my house from Ischia, and I sold a lot of stuff because it was easier than moving it all. So his theory, what he was trying to convince me of, was, oh, you know, I really like some of your stuff, maybe I can work with you and I can help you, like it was going to help me. Translation, it was all about what he could get for less is what the end of the story comes out to, but essentially he was interested in a lot of my brand new furniture, by the way, too. This is beautiful. And I put together an offer. You know, he started to try to offer, really lowball me, honestly. And I was like, no. He said, well, let me know what you're willing to sell it for. So we came up to what I felt was an agreement at the time. I think it was something like 3,600 euro. And I was gonna leave behind what the pieces that he wanted. And he was supposed to give me cash before everything got picked up for transportation, because I was putting my stuff in storage at my ex-boyfriend's place, Claudio. His family had a warehouse where they stored a lot of things because of the type of business that they had. It was a huge warehouse in over
in the Bagnoli area, actually, Agnano. And so, long story short, one day he comes over and he gives me 1,200 euro. And I learned this lesson a long time ago. You know, somebody told me, if somebody hands you money in Italy, like, and it's not just Naples, but it's also in life, it's everywhere. Some people have this idea that if I give you a certain amount of the money that I owe you, then in a certain way, this is a little bit of a tricky thing where their mindset is, well, I gave you money. What's the problem? I don't owe you any more money. So this is where you have to be really careful when you make an agreement and if you put it in writing. Now, we didn't put it in writing. It was just a verbal. Maybe we did. No, I might have put it in writing, actually, now that I think about it. But anyway, I did not feel really good about him giving me 1,200 euro. It did not sit well in my stomach. So I actually had to sit with it because I realized my body was telling me, see, I told you, like, you got to listen to your body. My body was telling me something wasn't right about the situation. He was complimenting and flirting with me and promising me to go by his store and, oh, you can get whatever dresses you want. And like, he was making all these promises to kind of smooth talk me, because that's what he did. He tried to smooth talk me. I wasn't really falling for it, but at the same time, I was kind of like, okay, something doesn't feel right. So the 1,200 euro wasn't enough money in my mind. I wasn't going to take 1,200 euro cash. I ended up giving it back to him and saying, I'm sorry, I changed my mind. And I didn't even go into a story or anything. Because the thing was, is he gave me the money and I said I needed to get all of it prior to my stuff being picked up. And he didn't deliver. And I wasn't about to be left with empty-handed, basically, and him profiting from the situation, which is what it felt like. And I trusted my gut on that one. Because in essence, in all actuality, that's exactly what ended up happening. Because the next day was when they were picking up all my stuff. So I said, here's your money. I changed my mind. You know, I changed my mind. And I'm glad I did. I'm grateful I did. On the other hand, the irony is that now somebody else has it and they don't want to give it back to me. How crazy is life, you know? When you recognize that sometimes you think you're helping others and that they'll help you in return. And this goes back to expectations and acknowledging when it doesn't always work out that way. It ends up being that there are unspoken expectations on all parts, whether it's yours or the other. And unless you're in a healthy situation, you end up with a learning, a lesson in the end. So, yeah, that was an interesting situation, dynamic, and I learned from it to trust my gut, and I was right. I'm grateful I did. Onward, back to the hotel.
Chiesa di San Giuseppe. Oh, maybe it's a little bit harder to see when I zoom out. There it is. Going back a little bit different of a direction. Again, doors. Beautiful doors. Portals. How pretty. Oh, so pretty, the wood. Cars. I didn't know Jeep made an electric car, but now you know. I didn't realize that. That's kind of cool. Doors. More doors. Always enamored by the doors. And there's angels overhead. Pretty, pretty. Taking a different direction. This person on the scooter thing. Quickly running out of battery by the sounds of it. But then again, going up a hill, it's kind of comical. It's almost like chug, chug, chug. That thing's huge too. Big door. Okay, not far.
Another church. That means no parking. Up on the hill. Gotta go downstairs if you go that way. I'm going toward the lights. That's a light, not the moon. The moon's actually on the other side of me. So this is the W. And I stayed here years ago when I was transferring back to the US after one job, staying in Rome for the night. They have a really amazing restaurant on the top, the rooftop. 5 Michelin rated. I'm not sure. That's kind of cool, huh? Anyway, we're going forward. And there's construction on that side of the sidewalk, so we're not going that way. Ah, oh, beautiful. So we're in the Via Vittorio Veneto area. Like I was saying, this is also, I believe, if not mistaken, it's also where the U.S. Embassy is up the street. If I remember correctly, I might be wrong about that, so don't quote me. But there's all the nice, really, well, a lot of the nice restaurants and hotels are up in this area. You typically can't go wrong staying here. I've always felt safe. And Chicka Chicka Boom nightclub. And the W. We're gonna go down the stairs and almost to my hotel, which is the one illuminated off to the left. Lit up. See, hello. Me and my shadow. Making my way home. Actually got a little warmer as I walked because I went uphill. And I enjoy a nice walk after dinner, especially on a night like tonight. The weather is nice. It's nice to be mobile. Movement. Movement is medicine. Okay. Finding our way. We cross the street all the way. There's a bus going. Definitely not going to challenge the bus. Alrighty. Safety first. That's me running from the taxi that's coming up behind me. This is actually coming from the backside. A little different walk around. Huh. More doors. doors, more doors. We have almost arrived. Bright lights. Big city. Look at that. That's crazy cool. The size of these beautiful stones. I mean, just taking my hand and putting it in front of it gives you perspective. My hands aren't that big. This looks inviting, doesn't it? Hey, Gucci. Well, of course it's inviting. This is actually my hotel. Make coffee, not war. Seriously, people. Life will never be the same. Flowers to light you up. And my hotel to invite me up. Hello, shopping queen. What do you have there in your bags? 2 bags? And another bag inside a bag with bags. The bag lady. Okay. This is not where I want to be. I'm trying to go up. Oh, that was tricky. I
many times I've had that happen to me. Getting caught in the door. I swear I hit the three. Somebody must have come up behind me. Oh yeah, I'm gonna sleep like an angel tonight. Sleeping in that beautiful bed. Comfy. Slippers and all, isn't that sweet? Windows are closed, that's what they do. They close the drapes, although it's slightly open right there. And yeah, time for me to get ready for bed. When you come back from a beautiful day to your bed turned down, inviting you to jump in and stay. That look of love right there behind me. Happy. Happiness. In one word, happiness. All right, I told you I'm ready for bed. Crazy hair. Hat off. Oh, wow. What a beautiful day. I'm quite content, quite happy with my bee. My beautiful bee. Isn't that beautiful? My gift to me on this trip. Buzzing around. Oh, it's kind of funny how my trip is coming to a close and that part there. Now, I didn't look down at the ground, to be totally honest with you, so I didn't find a feather, but the bee found me. Funny how that worked. So, time for night-nights. I'm gonna wash my face, brush my teeth, change my clothes, hop into that big bed, and say adieu, adieu, sweet dreams, my last night here in Rome Center. And then tomorrow, my girlfriend will pick me up, and I will stay with her out at her home until 3 a.m. when I have to go to the airport. So, I bid you adieu, sweet dreams, and I love you.